Assalamu alaikum everyone. Welcome to Easy Medicos. Our today's topic is polycythemia. Before starting, please subscribe my channel and also press the bell icon for more videos. So the objective of today's topic are: number one is polycythemia. Then the types of polycythemia. After that, we will discuss about the causes of polycythemia. Then the symptoms of polycythemia and diagnosis of polycythemia. So let's begin with the polycythemia. Polycythemia is a condition in which the increased concentration of hemoglobin in the blood, either through reduction of plasma volume or increase in red cells number. Now the types of polycythemia. There are different categories in which polycythemia divides, but we are discussing here the two major types of polycythemia. Number one is primary polycythemia and the number two is secondary polycythemia. But we are discussing here the secondary polycythemia first, because there is a reason behind it. After discussion, you will know the reason. Secondary polycythemia. Secondary polycythemia, it is a condition during which the tissues become hypoxic due to very low oxygen concentration in the breathed air, such as at the high altitudes, or because of failure of oxygen delivery to the tissues, such as in the cardiac failure. So the blood forming organs automatically start producing large quantities of extra RBCs. This condition is called the secondary polycythemia. The RBCs count commonly rises to 6 to 7 millions per millimeter cube, about 30% of the normal RBCs count. This is the body's compensatory mechanism, due to which it compensated the low oxygen level in the body and regulate the normal functions. A common type of secondary polycythemia is called a physiological polycythemia. It occurs in the natives who live at high altitudes of about 14,000 to 17,000 feet, where the atmospheric oxygen concentration is very low. To compensate this requirement, the body start developing more RBCs. The count is generally 6 to 7 millions per millimeter cube. This blood count allows them to perform well in the less oxygenated atmosphere. This is the physiological condition, that is the compensation by the body. This is not a pathological condition. Then primary polycythemia. Now the primary polycythemia, it is also called the polycythemia vera or erythemia. It is a pathological condition that is not the normal response of the body. In this condition, the RBCs count may be 7 to 8 millions per millimeter cube and hemocrit may be 60 to 70% instead of the normal 40 to 45%. Polycythemia vera is caused by a genetic aberration to the hemocytoblastic cells that produce the RBCs. The blast cells no longer stop producing RBCs when already too many RBCs are present already in the body. So in the polycythemia vera, not only hemocrit is increased, but also the total blood volume is increased as the WBCs and other blood cells are also produced, sometimes almost the twice the normal range of the blood. The viscosity of the blood sometimes increased from the normal of 3 times to 10 times the viscosity of water. So this is not the bearable condition for the body. The causes of polycythemia. First, the primary polycythemia. As we discussed earlier, primary polycythemia is a condition that occurs due to the genetic aberration in the hemocytoblastic cells. Secondary polycythemia is a physiological condition, as we discussed earlier. It occurs at being at the high altitude, obstructive sleep apnea, certain types of tumors or heart or lungs diseases that causes the low oxygen concentration in the body. For that compensation, body start production of more RBCs. Now, the symptoms of polycythemia. The symptoms of polycythemia vera may become more prominent over the time. The most common symptoms include, number 1 is excessive sweating, number 2 is blurred vision, number 3 is itchy skin, number 4 is reddish or purplish skin on the palms, earlobes and nose, bleeding, burning sensation in the feet and frequent nose bleeding. These are some few symptoms of polycythemia vera. Without treatment, people with polycythemia may also likely to experience the complications such as enlarged spleen, that is due to the more RBCs production, then blood clots, angina, heart attack or stroke, peptic ulcer or other blood disorders as it related with the blood. So these are the conditions polycythemia patient may experience. After that, the diagnosis of polycythemia. The diagnosis is important. Number one is the blood test, that is total blood count, in which the concentration of RBCs and all the blood cells measured. Second is the bone marrow biopsy. These two tests are major tests for the polycythemia. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, please subscribe my channel. And if you have any query, please write it in the comment section. And also remember to like, share, comment and save this video. And also share it with your family and friends.